What happened to you, Marcus? Where you realized this was something that was going to have an impact on the way you lived your life?
Well, I mean, again, I talk about adversity. You know, I don't want to go through a whole litany of things, but losing a child and a drowning accident, for me at the time, it didn't seem like I'd be able to come back, you know, to come back and return from. But I can remember talking to Coach around that time. I just remember feeling better about things as best as I could at that particular time. And that kind of set the ball rolling, started to remember some of the other things. And again, like I said, you know, we were almost programmed, and a lot of that stuff is kind of buried deep inside, and it takes something to happen in your life to kind of to spark the memory. And then, oh yeah, I remember Coach Wooden mentioning that.
Life is peaks and valleys, and I think the strength of character depends on how individuals can accept not permitting the peaks to get too high or the valleys too low. I hope by actions I tried to teach that, and I tried to teach it with my own children and grandchildren. But to think you're going to go through life and not have any adversities, that's crazy. You're going to have a lot of adversities.
You had so much impact on the lives of the men you coached, and you imparted so many lessons to them. What were the lessons that were most important to you when you were dealing with the loss of your wife of 52-plus years?
Well, that was pretty tough for a while, but had a wonderful family, supporting family and friends, and like many of them, came with me daily when I was going to hospital, and she was in there and various things. So I had the support of them and my minister, and then I got to the point where I could reflect on the good times, and so it's all those things entered in to helping me. But I'll never forget. But I can reflect. I see her in every room.
When Nell left, and we would all be down there, and Coach spent every single day at the hospital, and we would show up. I'd see all you guys there down there all the time, and it was just so tough and so sad. That was 20 years ago.
So his actions toward her spoke volumes.
You carried a cross at every game in the palm of your hand. Mm-hmm. Most people didn't realize that at the time.
I didn't want anybody to know it.
Why not?
A personal type of thing, but my minister gave me this in 1942 when I enlisted in the service, and that was always in my hand in time before I thought there would be any stress at all. It's a different cross. It has the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, and has the heart and the monad, and I've never seen it. They're about worn out, so you can hardly see them now, and I've had this since 1942. I've said the main thing that this was good for was officials.
The evil spirit.
I might have been a little more demonstrative at times.
Is there anything you want to say, Lynn, before we wrap this up?
You stuck around long enough for me to convey to you how you have enriched my life. It's taken me a long time, but I was always a little slow, I think. Slow on my feet, slow in a lot of ways. It's like going to a cheerleading contest when you have breakfast with Coach Wooden. The rest of the day you're just telling stories to other people and everything. It's just wonderful.
When we were here, we were too young to really appreciate it. And as he calls all of us that played for him his boys. And it's just such a real blessing to be one of his boys and to still have him around and be able to go out and spend time with him. It's one of the highlights of my life.
Kenny?
To have been guided, supervised by a great teacher, a great humanitarian, and someone who brought in the kind of spirited people like we have here, which made my experience at UCLA incredible.
I'll tell a story that really opened my heart up to him as a person was after my first divorce, and I was just devastated. And he said some words to me that changed my whole outlook. And that's when I really began to appreciate him beyond the coach.
What did he say?
Well, he just said, hey, if you don't love or don't trust, yeah, you get hurt sometimes, but you also miss out on great opportunities.
Marcus?
A couple of years ago, I was here watching my son play. After the game, my 14-year-old son, Mariah, found a Ted Williams autographed baseball enclosed in a glass case. He's like, Dad, look what I found. I was like, okay, put it back in there. And so we went home that night, and I thought about it. I was like, look, we can't keep that. We come down, we talk to an usher over here. He's like, Coach Wooden lost that baseball. It was Coach Wooden's baseball that we'd found. So the value of doing the right thing, even though it wasn't easy. So if he wasn't the coach at UCLA, I'd be the owner of a Ted Williams autograph.
I would like to thank you, Coach, for everything, all the lessons of life, all the gifts, everything that you've done. But I'd really love to thank you for your patience and to let you know that I love you.
Is there anything else you'd like to say, Coach?
Well, Jeremy, you can see here's an indication of why I feel blessed. I've been blessed so much. My family, children, grandchildren, 13 great-grandchildren all live within you know, an hour and a half or so of where I live, and my extended family, not just the ones here, but all those that I've been fortunate enough to have under my supervision through the years. And thank you, Jeremy, very much.
Do we have time to sing happy birthday?
No.
Oh, I think we have to.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
And more.
There again. I'm blessed. At my age, my hearing's not so good.
It's really getting teach some medicine. Thank you, Coach.